Hey guys, it's Sean. I am the leader of the Luxray Cutieflys. It's pretty late. I fight Matt, leader of the London Luxrays tomorrow. But yeah, it's pretty late. I got to school early in the morning. Not gonna lie, I've had a little bit to drink, so this is gonna be pretty relaxed. Team builder. I haven't really made any team builders for the first 2 weeks, just because I don't know those teams before. I just sort of put together, just saw what was good against the other person's team, and then I don't know, just added movesets and stuff. I didn't really go too in depth, but I mean, this team, this for the third week, I really like this team. I don't care if I lose. Like, I love my team for this week. But yeah, we are 2-0 2 weeks in. We are the only undefeated team, so that's pretty good. But this week we're against Matt. And I consider Matt personally to be one of the more better people in the league, competitive playing wise. So yeah, we'll jump into this team, and I'll just sort of go through why I chose these mons and their movesets. So, first off, we got Kyle, the Mega Deancey. I don't know, Kyle, beautiful, beautiful little thing. Also, Kyle likes his hidden power fire, so that's fun. I don't know, it could be a little giveaway if Matt pairs up the name Kyle with Hidden Power Fire. I don't know, it's not too in-depth. But yeah, so pretty much this week, you're probably looking at this and like, why has he got Endeavor? So pretty much, looking at Matt's team, I mean, Moonblast hits, the Keldeo, the Garchomp, just a bunch of other things. Pretty hard max special attack. The hidden power fire, it also hits the scissor. Like, he's 100% bringing this thing. He knows that I'm not bringing the Mega Aggron, so the only other Mega I can bring is the DNC, and just a bullet punch is just an easy way to end this thing. So I got the hidden power fire substitute. I was debating whether or not to bring Protect somewhere, just because DNC is like base 80 speed before it Mega evolves, and he's got a couple things with, you know, higher base speed than that that can take me out pretty easily. But I mean, if I just come in on, let's say, like the Rhydon or the Gorgeist, even, I'm pretty sure he's gonna bring that. It's a pretty good physical wall against some of my threats, like my Beatdown. If I can bring that thing off and then just substitute on his switch against a scissor, I'm pretty sure it's a one-hit KO with the hidden power fire, unless he's got, like, maybe, I think it's, like, a little bit over 100 EVs and special defense on his scissor, but we'll look at that right now. So, Mega Deancey, got our Kyle, we've got Mega Scissor, let's say bulky HP fire. You know, it doesn't do that much, but let's say he's adamant. Well, I guess that nature doesn't really work. But if he's not really running all of these special defense EVs, it pretty much takes him out. Like, I really don't expect him to be running that much. Same with, he could run, like, the max HP, but if he doesn't, I mean, he's probably going to do max attack just to get some powerful bullet punches off of my team. But yeah, pretty much, like, he comes in, I HP fire if I'm substitute, or I can predict the switch if I have a good matchup with my DNC. But yeah, that's pretty much what my DNC does for Moonblast and Hidden Power Fire. I don't know, it's a little bit heat this week in terms of his last two moves. Like, Matt, pretty much this is for, Matt knows I hate Reuniclus. It's so good. It can 1v1 teams if you're not prepared for it. He might not bring it just because he knows I'll prepare for this thing, but I just think this thing is too good for him not to bring. It's pretty much a substitute if he wants to bring it in, because he probably knows I can't really touch him with DNC. But with the substitute, I'm EV'd that way so that I can just keep substituting and moonblasting him. Eventually, I'll be down this I have my EV spread for HP set out so that if I can substitute four times and I'll be left with one HP. Then I can just endeavor, leave him at one. I'll probably be out of the sub and he'll probably kill me. But then that's just Reuniclus gone, because he'll probably run the magic coat or whatever his ability is that he doesn't take like stealth rock damage and stuff like that. He probably won't run the regenerator. So that thing will pretty much be done, because then after he killed it, something just come in, scare it out. Can't really do anything after that. All my mons pretty much outspeed it, except for my fish. But yeah, so that is my Mega Diancie for this week. Just speed EVs. It just outspeeds the Keldeo. He'll probably bring a Scarf Keldeo, I suspect. If he doesn't, then, I mean, Diancie just easily takes care of it. So I think he would bring the Scarf Keldeo. So yeah, that's that. Next mon, we have Cutieflys. You could say he's captain of the Cutieflys. But yeah, so Manaphy. This week, we're going with the Tail Glow set. Speed. He's like, this thing's base 100 speed. Tentacool. It's probably not running max speed. It's probably, if he does bring it, it's going to be a more bulkier set. So I didn't really worry about like trying to speed tie that or anything. And then just some other things outspeed it. But pretty much this thing outspeeds everything lower than the base 100, which he has a base 100 Tentacruel, but then after that everything jumps down to 80 and less. So this just outspeeds like Chandler, yeah, Mesprit, if he wants to bring that. But yeah, so pretty much this thing can come in Tail Glow. It pretty much takes a hit from anything. When I look at this, I don't know, Xcloud, who does bring Boom Burst, might be able to kill me. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, this Manaphy pretty much comes in Tail Glows. And then Single Beam. I'm pretty sure it kills the Reuniclus one shot. Even if it is running Special Defense. Manaphy. Reuniclus. Let's say Calm Mind. So my Single Beam, so pretty much Special Attack, plus 3. Heat now. Let's say, so what am I? I am Mars, yeah. That shit would be sad anyways, because I imported it, so I'm a little drunk, go home. But pretty much, if he wants to run, if he's not running Special Defense, he might look at this thing, and he'll see I Tail Glowed up. I might be modest. If he wants, he can do the calcs if he's at full. And he could say something like, oh, you know, he might be leftovers or just something else. I don't really suspect that he can kill me. So it might be, even if he's got more special defense. I'll just say he's like that. He's got a bunch of special defense. He'll say, oh, it can't kill me. I'll fire off an energy ball, get a lot of damage on this thing. Oh, with that expert belt, where is it? With that expert belt, it kills him pretty much unless he's running like max special defense, and I get a low roll. Yeah, it's got pretty much 50-50 chance knocking it out. But yeah, so that this Manaphy just takes care of that that Reuniclus, hits Keldeo. Scissor can come in and take, like, two hits. Pretty much, this thing takes out anything once it gets that Tail Glow off. And once again, I don't think he'll suspect the expert belt, so when he does a Kelk and something might live, it will probably die instead. So that's pretty much that. Just got a little bit of HP EVs left over. This thing's not so much heat. It's just a really good mon overall. Then I really like this thing. You'll see I'm scum. Don't look at that. But yeah, this week I'm bringing my Executor. Because really, when you look at this thing, what he likes to bring, I have the Sunny Day. I can just bring this in on a good matchup. And then also you'll see this thing is Heat Rock with Sunny Day 2. We'll get to that. But pretty much I get the sun up. And this thing, like, Hidden Power Fire, kills the Scissor he likes to bring. Solar Beam kills the Keldeo he likes to bring. Hopefully that Reuniclus is dead. Either that or it'll take massive damage. He won't really be able to touch me back unless he tricks or something. I don't know. But yeah, Jolteon will die. Exploud can probably take a hit. I don't know if he'll bring it. Excelgor, Hidden Power Fire, Rhydon, Solar Beam, Gorgeist, Hidden Power Fire. Just a lot of the popular things he likes to bring just die to this monster. So we got the Chlorophyll. And then we have, after the Solar Beam, or no, sorry, after the Sunny Day with the Chlorophyll. I forget why I evened it this way. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, yeah, it just outspeeds Excelgor. Excelgor's max speed. Once again, if he's got the Keldeo Scarf and does that speed, he could go for, like, an HP Ice or something, just bringing in. His thing would die. Executor can take the HP Ice pretty good. I think it does, like, 30 to 40%. But yeah, so pretty much this thing hits a lot of the mons that he likes to bring. And that's why I brought this, because pretty much I get rid of, like, the Reuniclus, and then a couple of other his mons that aren't really hurt by this are weakened. This thing just comes in and sweeps up his team. Once he got a little Icarus, flies pretty close to that sun. That's why I named that. Oh, yeah. With the item, I forget what I was thinking. It's like the Tapa berry or something. Don't quote me on that. I have no idea. But I was thinking of bringing the berry where it halves damage done by bug moves. Just because he could have the bug buzz. He could have... Well, he most likely will have the U-turn. And pretty much... Oh, yeah. Signal Beam on that if he wants to. And I was thinking, you know, this thing could just come in. He might go for the U-turn with Scissor. I live it, and I can Sunny Day up. But honestly, like, even if I live the bug move after, if he's got, like, the Scissor alive, he just pretty much bullet punch and take me out. So I sort of scrapped that idea. Same with, I was thinking, Focus Sash, but I sort of decided against it. I didn't really know, like, there wasn't really any good item I could do, maybe Leftovers. But I mean, Bright Powder, just like 100 accuracy moves become 90 accuracy moves. Could just catch him off guard. You know, he might think he's won the game. He comes in, goes to hit me and misses. I don't know. Just threw that on there. It's a little scummy, but oh well. It's not banned. So after this, we have my knees weak. His palms are sweaty. He's got little palms there. We got Hitmonlee. He's coming in with that Heat Rock. Got that Limber. I don't know, Reckless and Unburden really don't do anything for me. So, I don't know, Keezy's got that yellow color somewhere. So, yeah. So, for this, I brought the Rapid Spin. He's brought the Excelgor twice. I think it had spikes both times. I just sort of want to get a way of getting rid of hazards. He could also do, like, a Stealth Rock Garchomp if he wants that. Maybe his Rhydon he calls Aim. He could bring rocks to that too. But yeah, this thing just rapid spins away those hazards. Then we have the Sunny Day with the Heat Rock. Just this thing is pretty frail. You see that defense? It's like a little nub. It really just can come in, rapid spin, knock off, or Sunny Day. If I know this thing's just going to get killed right away, I just go for that Sunny Day. I get nice 8 turns of Icarus just coming in and messing up his team. And we also got the Blaze Kick. If he's got that Gorgeist or Scissor, Excelgor, he wants to bring that in, thinking he can take a move or something. I have that Blaze Kick as well. Pretty much, like, I've already decided, I have my mindset on this. If he brings the Excelgor, I see it on his team. Like, I'm leading off of this mon. I'm going right for the, I think I probably go off for the knockoff initially. Just a Keldeo or something wants to come in, get rid of that Choice Scarf. But pretty much, I'm leading this no matter what. If he wants to get a spike up, I can knock off and then just spam Rapid Spin. If he's got the Gorgeist, he can bring it in if he wants, but I do have that Blaze Kick. So yeah, this thing pretty much is just my lead. Gets rid of hazards, sets up for Icarus. and then potential knockoff that scarf. That's really all I'm worried about. Like, if this thing is not scarfed, Icarus has a field day. I'm really, like, when I made this team, I sort of ignored, like, Garchomp, Chandelier, Tentacruel, and Mesprit, like, the stuff he hasn't really brought. But, I mean, he's got some really good mons here he likes to bring, so I'm mainly prepared for that. I know it sort of bit me in the ass last week where, Steven brought the Excalibur, and I wasn't really prepared. I almost lost because of that. But, I mean, like, Manaphy, once this thing sets up, it takes care of all that. Like, it really doesn't, like, those mons can't really touch me once I get my stuff set up, and that's what I intend to do. Once again, like, this game will either go really well or really poor. But, yeah, on to the Duraregion Bogenfisk, however you pronounce that. These guys don't know that's, he's like that rainbow fish, like, kids cartoon slash book. Somehow I remember that from my childhood, so that's where I got that name. We had the Alamomola leftovers. I was thinking Rocky Helmet, but, I mean, the Scissor is really all that's affected by it. Garchomp is probably just going to go, if he does attack me with it, he would go for that Earthquake, doesn't get affected. Right on, Earthquake doesn't get affected. It's pretty much, I decided leftovers. I am specially defensive this week around. Just because, like, other than the Garchomp and the Rhydon, which he probably don't want to come in against me because I have that Scald anyway, same with Scissor. But yeah, so pretty much those won't come in against me. If they do, I really couldn't care less. This thing eats up the hit anyways. This week we've got Wish. I don't really have much defense this week. It's a lot of just hyper offense, setting up things like that. So, I mean, this is just sort of, I could switch in, take most hits, fire off a Wish, go back out to something, and then that, it pretty much gets full health from this thing's full HP. But yeah, so that's the Wish. Knockoff, I mean, like, I've been thinking about bringing Healing Wish or Toxic, but, I mean, Knockoff, once again, I want to get rid of that Scarf. You could be Leftovers on there, I want to get rid of that. You could be Scarf that. I just want to mainly have a way of dealing with some of items, some of his fast mons. Scald, best move in the game. And then we have the Mirror Coat here. And this Mirror Coat, it's pretty good. It's pretty good. We have the Keldeo. Keldeo, we'll do some Kelks here. We have that Alamomola. Kept adding in stuff, so there's going to be like a bunch of them. But yeah, so let's say we have the Keldeo first. Even if he just wants to be the all-out attacker, even more powerful, he should know Secret Sword does the most against me just because it's not resisted. If he wants to go for that Secret Sword, like, if he switches into this, I know he's going for a move. He hasn't really brought, like, a sub-call mine Keldeo yet. If he does, that would be hard to handle. But, I mean, he comes in, hits me with a move, I go for that Mirror Coat, and his Keldeo's gone. His Reuniclus wants to come in. Let's say Reuniclus. Let's just go with that. Let's go with a Energy Ball. It doesn't even do half, but, like, let's say it does 40% my HP. 40% of that. Let's just say, like, 250. Something like that. He hits me for 250, gets doubled to 500. It's automatically gone. Same with, let's say, he ends up bringing this Jolteon. If this Jolteon, let's just say, it's all-out attacker. Actually, I think Volt Switch, yeah. Let's say this thing comes in. Even if he wants to go for Thunderbolt, I hope he goes for Volt Switch. But if he goes for Thunderbolt, I can also easily, again, just Mirror Coat, kill it. If he Volt Switches into something, it's beautiful. I Mirror Coat, whatever he decides to come in, it just drops. It dies. It's gone. So that is why I brought this. Once again, just Regenerator, get some health. That's pretty much that. And then we have my final mon, Beatdown. The big black Kyurem Black. This week, I decided to bring a Life Orb variant. I had Roost instead of Earth Power. But then he's got things like Tentacruel and Chandelure that I haven't really calc'd it at all. I assume it hurts harder than a Dragon Claw. And also, I think Earth Power hits the Scissor for the most. But, pretty much, this Kyurem, it does work once a lot of his stuff is weakened. Once again, I have the Naughty Nature, so it's plus attack. My speed outspeeds everything with 80 base and less. So yeah, this thing pretty much comes in. It can Earth Power, it can substitute Dragon Claw, Ice Beam. He, like, pretty much a bunch of his walls that he might bring, let's say the Gorgeist or the Rhydon. So I think both weeks I brought Scarf Kyurem just to sweep with Outrage. If he wants to bring like a super defensive Rhydon or Gorgeist, he sees this thing come in, he wants to swap in. Sure, I can hit it with the Dragon Claw. It's probably the best move to go there and then, assuming that Scissor's probably dead. I don't even know if he would want to bring it in. He'd probably just bring one of his walls in right away. But it gets hit with that Dragon Claw, does nothing. Fire off an Ice Beam, and like it kills the Rhydon. Does a lot to the Gorgeist. To say it's defensive, but we gotta bring in the Kyurem Black. Where are you? There he is. So yeah, Ice Beam. I mean, like, no matter what, I 2-hit KO no matter what. If it comes into Dragon Claw, even if this thing's, like, fully special defensive, it's still, like, 45 to 75. It drops two. So, that's pretty much all of it for my team. Substitute, once again. Like, if that Gorgeist does come in, I can just go for that, Substitute as well. He probably packs a little Wisp or something, so that'll catch him off guard. I can kill that, and then something else comes in. I get a free powerful hit off on that. So that is pretty much my team for this week. Hoping to go 3-0. That's pretty much it. Like, this team, it's a lot of things that can catch Matt off guard with that. This thing sets up. This thing, you know, gets that sun off. This thing can get a little surprise kill. If he doesn't calc it with expert belt, you might assume it's just something else that doesn't add damage. That mirror coat, like, when I look at it, it puts in a lot of work is, like, if it works. And then this, like, pretty much this week, I'm going to rely on the Manaphy and this to just sweep his team, assuming he brings the mons he likes to bring. So this and this pretty much win. Everything else just, you know, gets damage off, kills something, just gets away hazards, hopefully kills something, weakens something else, and then my sweepers. So that is the plan for the week. Hopefully it's a fun game and not me get destroyed because I only brought like one thing to take hits and everything else dies if he sets up with something. But yeah, so play tomorrow around 11. It's like 11:40 right now. I've got class at 8 in the morning, so I'm going to bed. So we'll see what happens tomorrow. Bye.